You missed all the action.
Anyone hurt?
Well, only the householder, Mr. Raymond Halford.
Ray Halford?
Yes.
I know that name. Morning.
Good morning.
How you doing? Not any luck, please.
Hi, P.S. Morgan, Sunhill.
Sorry, Sergeant. Well, we do get the odd sightseer trampling all over the evidence. Station Officer McRae.
D.C. Woods.
Here.
So what's the situation?
They've taken Mr. Halford to St. Hughes. Smoke inhalation. He should be all right in a couple of days.
Do we know how it started?
Well, the Fire Investigation Unit have sent their forensic bloke over. Best have a word with him.
Is it suspicious, then?
Oh, yeah. I would think so. Anyway, he's upstairs.
Cheers. Where's the Socko?
Not here yet.
Okay, Alan, stay down here, will you? Check the doors and windows, see if there's any sign of a forced entry.
Okay.
Hello?
In here.
Hi, D.S. Morgan, Sunhill.
Hi.
Oh, seems to be worse up here. Any ideas?
Well, my guess is it started out there on the landing. There are traces of an accelerant on the carpet.
What sort?
Almost certainly it'll be petroleum-based.
Here, I've made a preliminary report.
Oh, thanks. Oh, can you make sure the Socko get those?
Yeah, no problem.
Cheers. Anything?
Not that I could see. Socko might say different.
Right, well, the FIU rings it started on the landing, so that rules out petrol through the letterbox job.
Not unless they're a genius with a squeezy bottle.
The occupant of the house was one Raymond John Halford.
Ray Halford? What idiot called the fire brigade? Halford's a villain girl with a lot of fall, although he doesn't operate on our patch so much.
The name rings a bell. I'm sure he had a run-in with Barton Street not so long ago. Susie, would you check that out? Find out what he's been up to, and more importantly, who'd want to do him some real harm.
What time did it start?
We think about 6 a.m.
I'll check out the local milk round. Somebody might have seen something.
Good idea.
What about the neighbours?
Well, they've given us the kids' names and addresses. Ellen and Joe are following that one up.
Jerry Hawford.
Yeah?
D.S. Morgan, D.C. Woods, Sun Hill. Can we have a word?
Go on, eh?
About your dad?
Oh, yeah. What's he done?
Well, there was a fire at his house earlier this morning.
What?
It's okay, it's going to be fine.
Well, where is he then?
St. Hughes. We think it was arson. You weren't with him then last night? Terry?
Nah. I was down at Boozer, the yew tree.
The people there who can confirm that, are there?
Oh, nice one. What do you reckon? I'd set fire to my own dad's house.
No, but whoever did had access to the house, possibly a key. All we're trying to do is eliminate people from our inquiry.
Well, you can eliminate me, because there are others who can get into that house easy enough without you accusing family.
Who else can get in?
Family stick together.
Who, Terry?
Just people mouthing off.
Yeah, what do they say?
Nothing. It's not important. We don't even listen to it.
If you know someone who might have wanted to hurt your father...
Then I'd tell you, wouldn't I? What do you think? I don't want it sorted. Now, if you don't mind, I'd like to go and see my old man.
Don't go getting any stupid ideas about sorting this one out on your own, Terry.
Well, thanks for the advice.
So how comes I've got the logbook?
I keep telling you, idiot. I left it in the...
Who's a flaming idiot?
That's my opinion.
Wait, Alden.
Oh, at last.
Mr. Pilgrim?
Yeah, that's me. And that's my car that I reported stolen 2 days ago.
Yeah, that's right. Actually, I think I took the details, didn't I?
That's right, you did. Well, here it is. I've done your job for you. Now, it's my car.
That is not your flaming car! It's my car!
Yeah, all right. There's no need to shout, Mr...
Downs. Stan Downs.
Downs. Can I see the registration document, please?
I only bought it 2 days ago, so it's still got his name on it.
And where did you buy the car?
Off a mate of a mate. I buy old cars, do them up, and then sell them on for a bit. I do not buy hot motors.
Did you get a receipt?
And a logbook. Only because it was in the car when it was nicked. Now, what's the problem, officer? You can see it's the car I reported as stolen. They're my documents.
Yeah, but it's not quite as simple as that, sir. This is quite a tricky area. Not exactly official looking, is it?
It's a private sale. You don't expect someone to have a letter read and a rubber stamp.
Mr. Pilgrim? Sorry, sir, but as I see it, you're going to have to go through the courts to get your car back.
Thank you.
You are joking.
No, afraid not. See, I'm satisfied that Mr. Downs bought the car in good faith.
Well, I'm not.
No, well, fair enough. But basically, until you put that across in the courts, the car must remain with Mr. Downs.
But that's ludicrous.
Can't argue with the law, mate.
Excuse me, do you know which room Lynn Halford's in?
Who's asking?
Do you know?
Yeah, I'm Lynn Halford.
D.S. Morgan, D.C. Woods, Sun Hill. Can we have a word, please? He's okay.
What do you mean he's okay?
Well, he wasn't burnt, but he should be in St. Hugh's for a few days. Just breathed in a bit of smoke, that's all.
He's going to be all right?
He should be fine.
So how did it start, then?
We're not sure yet.
Having a fag in bed, probably. I've told him 100 times, but he never listens.
Well, actually, we think it might have started deliberately. Arson. Someone wanted to harm your dad, Lynn. Can you think of anyone who might have wanted to do that?
Do you know my old man?
We know of him.
So you know half of London's villains could be in the frame? He didn't go out of his way to make friends.
Anyone in particular? Any recent disagreements?
Not that I know of.
Terry seemed to think there might have been someone who had a grudge against your dad.
Terry knows about the fire, does he?
We saw him before we came here.
Right.
Are he and your father close?
Close enough.
And you? You get on well?
Pretty well, most of the time.
How long have you lived here, Lynn?
3 months.
So like?
It's all right.
How come you don't live at home? It's a big house your dad's got, it's plenty of room.
I don't know. I get sick of being the dog's body.
You haven't had a row with him or anything, have you?
No.
Do you go around there often?
Sometimes.
Let yourself in, do you?
Why?
No reason.
So where were you last night, Lynn?
Here.
Anyone see you?
No. Look, you think I've had something to do with this, don't you?
You probably want to get off and see him.
Hey?
Your dad.
Oh, right. St. Hughes, wasn't it?
Dad! Shut up! I'm telling you he's dead!
Oi, you! Shut it!
Terry Alford, Sarge.
We're a Mill Street, Sarge. We saw Jimmy Tate and Rambo there having a go at each other.
He attacked me in my shop. It was self-defense.
You were giving a pretty good of account of yourself when we arrived.
Right, name?
James Murray Tate. You think that's a man's way to sort it out, Tate? Sneaking around to someone's house in the middle of the night. Look, just leave it, right?
Address?
49 Nelfield Road, Sun Hill.
Date of birth?
7/11/39.
Right, empty your pockets.
You got a grievance, why don't you come and see me?
I've already told you once.
Shut it! This lies, that's why!
Right, Mr. Tate, you have the right to have someone informed of your arrest.
You ain't got the guts to face me, have you?
Don't you talk to me about guts, you little slag! Your family don't know the first thing about guts!
Well, come on then, come on, let's sort it!
Listen, don't push it, I've warned you! Right, you have the right to a solicitor. And to see a copy of the code of practice. You exercise this right now, any time during your stay of detention. Do you understand?
Yes.
Right, sign there. Number 3. Right, you. Where should we start? GBH. Assaulting a police officer. Resisting arrest.
4 months ago, Ray Halford and Jimmy Tate's son, Colin, were held at Barton Street in connection with an armed robbery.
What was it?
Sub post office. Nasty job. Sawn off shotgun scared a lot of old ladies. Anyway, 2 weeks ago, Colin was found guilty and sentenced to 6 years.
What about Ray?
Well, this is the real gem. He was never charged. Not enough evidence.
So how come the boy was done?
Ray grassed him up.
And this is common knowledge, is it?
The Tates knew it.
The first I knew of any fire was when Terry attacked me and accused me of trying to kill his old man.
So why would he do that?
Because of what's gone on between his dad and me since Colin was charged.
And what is that?
My boy is doing 6 years because of him. I think Ray Halford is scum. I make no bones about it. I despise the man.
Enough to want to see him dead?
Well, I wouldn't weep any tears if he died. But I'm not fool enough to do it myself.
How old is Colin, Jimmy?
22.
6 years is a lifetime at his age.
Oh, don't I know it?
You must be very angry.
Very. But tell me, sweetheart, if I kill Ray Halford, what good would it do my boy? Wouldn't get him out any quicker, would it?
So how come your two families know each other then, Jimmy?
I grew up with Ray. I went to school with him.
He was Colin's godfather.
His godfather?
Was.
You must ask yourself how he could have done what he did, Jimmy. And I wouldn't blame you for wanting to harm him.
Really? That's good of you.
Maybe you didn't want to kill him. Maybe you just wanted to hurt him as much as he'd hurt your family.
Well, that's very interesting. Because I don't really think that's possible.
Let's go back to where you were last night.
I was at home with my wife.
All night?
Well, once I go to bed, I do tend to stay in it till the morning.
No, don't get cocky, Jimmy.
I'm not getting cocky, I'm getting angry. I wasn't there, it's nothing to do with me.
You won't mind if we search your house then, eh?
Do what you like. You won't find anything.
Sarge.
Lovely.
Come on, Jimmy.
Sarge, my word.
Yeah, I'll see you outside, Alan, okay?
Is that Jimmy Tate?
Yeah, we're going to search his gaff now. He's in the frame for the arson.
Not according to my information. The milkman I've just spoken to said he saw someone running out of Holford's house about 6 o'clock this morning.
So what's the problem?
About a footy night. It was dark, but he reckons it was a short bloke. 5'3", 5'4". Doesn't exactly fit in with Tate's description, does it?
Hello, again.
Mr. Pilgrim. Can I ask you, sir, how Mr. Downs' 2CV comes to be parked outside your front door?
I bought it. Off a mate, of a mate. Look, the receipt.
Not anyone could have done this.
That's as good a receipt as Downs had. I presume he sold it to someone after our little meeting this morning. Look, I like my car, so I bought it back.
You don't seriously expect me to believe that, do you, sir?
What are you going to do, officer? Nick me for stealing my own car?
So what's our Colin been up to then?
Don't know till we've talked to him.
He's a funny one. Cool as you like, usually. These last 2 weeks.
What?
Don't know, he's been edgy.
Maybe it's a court case.
Nah, he always knew he was going down. Occupational hazard, isn't it?
Does he get many visitors?
Did when he was on remand.
What sort?
Usual rogues gallery.
Cheers.
Colin Tate.
There you go. As I say, when he was on remand, he was getting one visit a day. Now he's only allowed 2 a month.
Who's this Shana David? She used to come here 3-4 times a week.
Girlfriend, I'd imagine.
Do you have an address for her?
Where the visiting orders are sent. Excuse me.
Tate never mentioned a girlfriend.
No, he didn't, did he? Worth checking, though.
Sorry, folks. Tate won't speak to you.
Well, we've already squared it with legal visits. He's agreed.
Well, he's changed his mind. Someone must have got in contact with him. The wonders of the prison network, eh?
Reg, I've just had a call about a disturbance in Glade Road. There's a bloke attacking a 2CV with a plank of wood.
Are you winding me up, Sarge? That's Gary Pilgrim's Road.
Yeah, Sarge.
Davey.
Lynn! What are you doing here?
I'm visiting my friend Shana. What do you want?
Well, we'd like a word with her. Can we come in?
If you want. She's not in.
Where is Shana?
Shopping.
So she's a mate of yours, is she?
Well, it's not illegal, is it?
Did you hear what happened to your brother? He had a go at Jimmy Tate. Surprised you didn't mention that little family feud, Lynn.
What feud?
Well, between your family and the Tates.
Well, don't get involved. I lead my own life.
I don't believe that, Lynn. Jimmy Tate says you were like a sister to Colin.
Yeah, well, he lives in the past, don't he?
How do you mean?
Look, I thought you came here to talk to Shana.
She's not here, is she?
How do you mean he lives in the past?
I don't know. He wants things to be like when we were kids. Things change. You get older, wiser.
That's no reason for families to turn on each other, though. Is it?
Did you know that Shana visits Colin inside?
Of course.
So what is she? Friend? Girlfriend?
I don't know. We don't talk about it.
Well, she can tell us all about him when she gets back.
Well, she won't tell you nothing.
Why?
Because she don't like talking about him. It upsets her.
How do you know? You've just said you never talk about him with her.
I just know. All right.
Do you ever go to see Colin, Lynn?
Why do I want to go and see him?
Lynn, all we have to do Let's get a photo of you up to the prison and someone will identify you. Did you visit him?
Yeah.
Did you use Shanna's name? Why?
Because of the rest of them. Jimmy, Terry, my old man, they're going mad.
What exactly is your relationship with Colin then?
We're just friends.
Lynn, I think it might be a good idea if we continued this chat down at the station.
Mr. Downs, if you don't stop doing that, I'll have to arrest you.
What for, officer? Dead in my own car?
It's not your car anymore.
But if it's not mine, by the same token, it can't be his, can it?
Well, look, yes, it can be. If he's got a receipt as you had, he's entitled to the same benefit of the doubt as you were, right?
All right, fine. In that case, I'll just pick up my bits. Hubcaps, filler, nice, shiny new number plates. $9.99 each.
Right. Mr. Pilgrim, do you want me to arrest him for criminal damage?
Listen, as long as he doesn't go mad, let's just leave it, eh?
Sorry?
As long as he doesn't make it worse than when it was stolen from me.
You mean you don't want to press charges?
No, look, he's got a point, hasn't he? And anyway, I like my car battered. I don't want a boy racer 2CV.
The old ones are in the boot. Thank you, Constable, for all your help.
I've got some work to do, actually, so if you don't mind. All's well that ends well. Hey.
Yeah, she's still sticking to her story that she's just a friend. We've had a word with one of the prison officers, though, and apparently they were all over each other. So her lover gets sent down for 6 years by her father.
Nice.
Have you got onto social services yet? Oh, yeah. Yeah, Yak's had a contact. The history of bad relations with her father. Apparently she has to be rehoused a few months back. She made allegations of abuse from her father.
Sexual?
No, physical. Beatings, drunken violence, that sort of stuff.
Well, see what she says.
Yeah, well, don't expect much. She's like a cornered cat. We only got her down here by threatening to nick her for the visiting scam.
Oh, yes, impersonating a prison visitor. Serious offence.
Okay, Lynn. I want to ask you more about your relationship with Colin.
I've already told you. We're friends.
Do you usually kiss and cuddle with your friends?
Well, he was going down for a stretch. He was depressed. I was just giving him a bit of comfort, that was all.
But surely, if Colin was a close friend, you must have been very angry with your dad.
Why? They're adults, ain't they? They can handle themselves.
Doesn't it bother you?
What?
The fact that your father grassed up his own godson.
Get real. What, do you think there's some cosy little rules that everyone has to live by? It's not like that.
I know. But that doesn't mean to say people have to accept it.
Believe me, I get on with my own life. I just don't get involved in other people's.
I don't believe you. You obviously do care about people.
Oh, really?
Lynn, you've told us you get on very well with your dad. Would you still say that? Would you?
Yeah.
So you get on great with your dad, and you don't resent him for what he did to Colin or what he did to you?
That's it.
So you won't mind if we search your place?
Do what you want.
You know, Lynn, if there's anything there, no matter how small, that connects you with that fire, we'll find it. It doesn't seem to bother you, Lynn, the trouble you're in. Okay, we might as well search Shana's place too.
Hey? Well, you can't do that. I've had enough of this. I've come down here of my own free will. I mean, are you nicking me or what?
Okay, then.
What?
You're nicked.
I told you I wasn't happy about her using my name.
Shana, please, don't say nothing.
I don't want any trouble, Lynn.
So, when she came here this morning, was she carrying anything? Shana, there's no point lying to us. Lynn's in enough trouble as it is. You'd only make it worse.
It's under the sink, in a carrier bag.
You bitch, what do you think you're doing? No, you've done!
I'm sorry, Lynn.
Petrol.
Couldn't be able to chuck your favourite jacket, could you, eh?
Thanks very much. Bye. Susie, that was forensic. They've identified the accelerant on the carpet at Holford's house. So if we need a match...
Nice one.
It's not mine.
So whose is it?
Shana's.
You know, she said it was yours.
Well, she's lying.
Lynn, I want to know why you moved out of your father's house.
I already said.
Well, you've said lots of different things. I want the real reason.
Because he was hitting me.
Well, you told us before that didn't bother you.
Well, it did.
I don't think that's the only reason you left, was it? I mean, lots of girls put up with what you did. They learn to live with it. Lynn, you've got to tell us the truth now. There's no point in this anymore. Was it because of Colin? For the tape, Lynn has just nodded. Tell us about it.
I love Colin. That's it.
You love him? In what way?
Well, I'm gonna marry him.
So you left home because of what your dad did to him?
Yeah. He's evil.
Who?
My dad. He's evil. He just hasn't got anything good in him.
Is that why you set fire to his house? Lynn, we have enough evidence already to charge you.
Yeah. That's why I set fire to my dad's house. Because he's an evil, stinking pig. Quite sad that, ain't it?
How did you do it?
I poured some petrol on the landing. And I threw a match on it.
And you knew what you were doing?
I wanted to kill him.
Why now?
I don't know. I suppose it was something Colin said. About me starting to show.
How do you mean?
I'm pregnant.
How many months?
5.
And Colin's a father?
It must have happened just before he went inside. When he said about me starting to show, well, it just brought it all back home to me.
What?
Everything, really. You know, Colin's been so good to me. He's gentle and loving. I've never had that before. And now it's just been taken away from me. I sort of could cope with that. I had before, I could again. Our baby's done nothing to deserve that. Why should our baby suffer? I mean, it's not fair, is it? Well, is it?
No. It's not fair.
You know, it's going to be a toddler before Colin gets the chance to be a proper dad. And he'd be a great little dad, Colin would.
I'm sure he would.
And out of all the things that my old man's ever done, just couldn't forgive him for that.